The day Joe Howard set up a telegraph in his backyard, he was so proud of it that he had to show it to his next door neighbor, Alice Marshall.
How's it work, Alice?
It's marvelous. You press a button over there, and there's a click here. It's just like magic.
Well, it's not magic. The thing that makes the telegraph work is a magnet.
A magnet?
Sure, you know what magnets are.
Well, sort of.
So, Joe took Alice into his workshop to show her hidden of magnets.
You see, Alice, these are bar magnets. This one is a magnet. These round ones are cylindrical. Even the needles and the compasses are magnets, too. All these are called permanent magnets because they keep their magnetism for a long time.
But, Joe, what does the N and S on the magnet mean?
Well, a long time ago, somebody discovered that a certain kind of iron ore called lodestone was magnetic. When a lodestone is hung in the air, it always has one end pointing north, so they call this the north end and the other south. When you put a bar magnet in this stand, it also points north and south, so its ends, we call them poles, are lettered N and S. When you put a magnet in a case, you have a compass that points to the magnetic north.
Look, my magnet pushes yours away. But this way they stick together. Why do they do that?
Look at the letters on the poles.
This is the north pole of mine and the north pole of yours. And they push each other apart. But if the north pole of mine and the south pole of yours... Oh, I see. If the poles are the same, they separate. But if they're different, they pull together.
Alice soon learned more about magnets. For instance, some of the things they will pick up, like nails and tacks. Then Joe shook out a little pile of iron filings on the table. And Alice found that the magnet picked them up, too. She also learned some of the things they won't pick up, such as rubber, wood like a pencil, and a glass marble. When a wire nail is held against the magnet, it becomes temporarily magnetized and attracts other nails. But soon after the magnet is taken away, the nail loses its magnetism and the other nails fall off.
Joe, can you make a magnet?
Sure, I can take any small piece of hard steel. A hacksaw blade will do. It's not a magnet now. It won't pick up the filings. But when I stroke one end of the blade on one end of a magnet, it becomes magnetized.
It really is a magnet. But Joe, can a magnet attract things if there's something else in between? Oh, something like glass or paper or wood?
Sure, I'll show you.
Joe set up a large pane of glass so they could put a magnet underneath it. And Alice put her metal charm pin on the glass.
Say, magnetism does go through glass, doesn't it?
That shows how magnetism is different from electricity. Electricity won't go through glass or paper or rubber. They cover electric wires with rubber so it won't get through and hurt anybody.
Say, I wonder what magnetism looks like.
Well, I can show you what a magnetic field looks like.
A magnetic field is the space around a magnet where its influence is evident. It makes a regular pattern. When Joe arranges a straight bar magnet under the sheet of glass and then sprinkles iron filings on the glass, the filings make a pattern that shows the field of force running from pole to pole. The Earth itself is just like a huge bar magnet with lines of force running from pole to pole. A compass tells direction because it follows these lines of force and always points to the northern part of the Earth, the North Magnetic Pole.
But Joe, what does all this have to do with your telegraph set?
I'm coming to that. The telegraph uses an electromagnet.
What's an electromagnet?
That's a magnet you make by winding wire around a soft iron core like this bolt. Then you connect the wire to some cells and put in a switch. When the current is turned on in the coil of wire, the iron core becomes magnetized, but it loses its magnetism as soon as the current is turned off. The telegraph set works the same way when hooked up to the cells. The key is just another kind of a switch. When closed, current flows through the circuit.
The main part of the sounder is an electromagnet attached to the batteries and the key. Here's a good way to see what really happens. There's the electromagnet, the wires to the battery, and the key. Up at the top is an iron bar, kept away from the magnet by a little spring over at the left. When the key is pressed, current flows through the coil, and the electromagnet pulls the bar down. The bar will be held down only as long as the key keeps current flowing in the coil. Each time the key is pressed down, the electromagnet pulls the bar down, and when the key is released, the spring pushes the bar up. It's the up and down movement of the bar that makes the clicking sound.
I think I understand about your telegraph, Joe. But do people use electromagnets for anything else?
Sure, a lot of things. A telephone receiver works a lot like a telegraph, only it's more complicated. And electromagnets are what make electric motors work.
How do they do that?
Well, you see, electromagnets have north and south poles just like permanent magnets. They attract or push away from the north end of the compass needle. When I change the direction, current flows through the wire, and the poles of the electromagnet are reversed. Now the poles are just the opposite of what they were before.
I can understand that, but what does it have to do with an electric motor?
You'll see when I start the model I made last year for the hobby show.
Joe's model is a simple electric motor. In the center is a bar electromagnet mounted on an axle. This is the armature. And here are two more electromagnets, one a north pole, the other a south pole. With each half turn of the armature, the current in the rotating electromagnet is reversed. So the like poles of the armature and field magnets are continually pushing the armature around to the point where the poles are not alike and so attract each other. But just as the unlike poles come opposite each other, the current is reversed again and the revolution continues. Thus, the armature is kept in constant motion as long as the current is flowing.
I never knew how important electromagnets are.
And there's another thing you ought to know about magnets.
What's that?
Well, besides making magnets with electricity, you can make electricity with a magnet.
Can you?
Watch. We attach this coil of wire to the galvanometer, which will show any flow of current in the wire. When I move a magnet through the coil, the galvanometer shows that current is flowing in the wire. I can do the same thing continuously with the model we used for the motor.
In this model, Joe has everything he needs to generate electric current. Those batteries are only to make the electromagnets work. So the magnetic field created between the two outside magnets will be cut by the coil of wire on the armature when it is turned. This produces an electric current in the coil, just as moving the magnet through the coil of wire did. When a light bulb is put in place of the galvanometer, the generator does useful work.
It's fun making our own electricity.
And it's important, too. Think how many things we use depend on electricity.
And they're all made by magnets.
Say, we've been talking a good deal about magnets. Do you think you know all about them?
Well, not all about them, but I do know quite a bit.
Yes, Alice has learned many things about magnets. Every magnet has two poles, north and south. Like poles repel each other. Unlike poles attract each other. Magnetism will go through things like glass and paper. Around every magnet there is a field of force. The Earth is like a huge bar magnet with a field of force and poles that attract compass needles. By passing an electric current through a coil of wire around a soft iron core, an electromagnet is made. Electromagnets can be made to do work in an electric motor and to make electricity in a generator. From giant complex dynamos to simple compass needles, magnets play an important part in making our lives safer and more enjoyable.